Good evening, Elfringham. How are you doing? How are you doing, Kate?
I'm doing really well. How are you?
I'm feeling good.
Good.
Yeah, I've had a good few days. Got on top of a few things.
What have you been doing?
What have I been doing? I've been making some adjustments to the studio, not that you can tell. Yeah. Except we do have a phone number temporarily up there at the moment. If you'd like to get in touch with us, anything that we're talking about tonight, any of the subjects that we touch on, you can give us a call. 07874 055611. Does that sound good to you?
That sounds good to me. We're also going to be doing the draw for the Warhorse tickets tonight. We're going to be drawing that at the end of the show. So keep your eyes peeled. Your name might be pulled out. Keep your eyes peeled as well. Okay. Shall we start? I'm going to start on a bit of a somber note today. I think it's a subject that's been going around the Altrincham area for quite a few weeks now. As most of you are aware, it was the funeral of Caspar Blackburn today, whose body was found on the Bridgewater Canal. I think I speak for all of us when we offer our condolences to his family. But it does beg the question, should there be CCTV along the canal? Now, I know there is a petition on Facebook going around at the moment for this to be installed and put in place. But how far can the council stretch for this? I mean, should they be really doing this to save people's lives? Because I've been doing some research and there's been about 87 deaths up to now in the last 7 years, and about 29 of them are unexplained.
I was surprised at that figure.
Yeah.
Really, that many?
Yeah. There was one, if you remember, on the 7th of July. This one was near the Deansgate Locks. There's a body found there. So if you're walking along the canal, stay safe.
Yeah.
Don't walk there to take a shortcut if you're going home from the pub, because it just isn't safe. And even if you fall out with your friends, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, just stay together. Because I think what is happening at the moment is pretty tragic. We're finding people who, well, we're not finding people, the police or people who wander upon them are finding bodies. And it's sad, it's terrible for the families. And you know, it could be at any time of day, but what are your thoughts on this for the CCTV? What do you think?
It's not going to be cheap, is it?
It's not, but...
to cover all that area.
It's not. Should it be in designated areas? What do you think? Or should the council just completely get it done?
I think first of all you need to look at the hotspots.
Yeah.
Don't you? If there are any hotspots, and
yeah.
Find out why. Why is that a hotspot?
Yeah.
And approach it that way rather than go straight in Big Brother. Yeah. Maybe it's not always necessary.
Well, if you have any thoughts about this, please do call us. The number is behind. So yeah. That's our sombre note for the evening. However...
Hi to Si Steele, who's joined us. Thanks for being there, Si.
Hi. So, what's your news? What do you have?
What's my news? Well, I said before that we've made a few adjustments to the studio here. We'll try with these phone calls. I did notice the signal isn't so good over at this end. We'll have to see to that. But please, numbers up there, give us a call. So a little bit of movement at our home at A4. I'd just like to mention that tomorrow evening, Air Gallery here at A4 Studios are opening a new exhibition called Curiosities. The last two exhibitions, being on the inside here, being able to see them ahead of time, is some of it, wow, some of the stuff that's out there. And this Curiosities is set to be another one of those. They've finished setting up just tonight. I do recommend you come down and have a look and support these guys here at A4. They're doing all this for the Altrincham community.
Yeah.
I'm hoping I may be able to drop a little teaser video with some of the people from Air Gallery tomorrow.
Yeah.
And I'll be getting some pictures for the page of the opening ceremony tomorrow night for this exhibition.
Just in case you hear any noise, it's actually some of the artists putting together well, they're doing welding work actually for some of the exhibition
pieces.
Work
down the bottom
so,
there, yeah,
so do drop in and see what's going on, because I think it's going to be pretty spectacular. And will be interesting to see what they come up with. There's some really talented people out there. So come and have a look. Come and visit us as well. So, Ivan.
Yeah, can I? This is quite relevant, actually. Si Steele says, it's been a while since I've been, since he's been on here. Any idea who's switching the Christmas lights on this year?
I believe
you may be prepared for that.
I do have this. So, Si, it's going to be on the 18th of November in Stamford Square. So at 4:30 p.m. we're going to have the Key 103 breakfast team. So you've got Mike Toolan, is it Mike Balsam as well? I don't listen to Key 103, really sorry. And also Brooke Vincent from Coronation Street is going to be there. They'll be taking the stage, entertaining the crowds. There's also going to be lots of live performances from local singers and also a local Altrincham's children's choir. So 5:30 again when the lights will be switched on. Come down, it's going to be fantastic. And I think you and maybe Chris are going to be covering this.
Chris is one of the Altrincham hosts. So
oh, is he?
He might be helping out in his pink jacket. Yeah.
You're not going to miss him.
Rather suits in that colour, I have to say. But yeah, we will be there. We're hoping to get up front now and we'll be live streaming something, I imagine.
That'd be great.
Watch out.
So yeah, if you want any more details, we'll put some on for you as well. We'll put that on the Altrincham News Facebook site. Now I've got a little treat for Andy today. You've heard me talking about Sweet Octopus before. So I've gone and done it. I've gone to see Sweet Octopus and I've brought a few cakes today.
Did you say cakes?
I've said cakes. I've got four cakes for you and pudding. To try, so it's a mixture.
Okay.
Do you want to go and grab them, Andy?
Wouldn't that be that over there?
That might be that over there. And I've got to say, I've tried them, so I know how good they are. I've got a spoon. So I've got a spoon and a fork. I don't know why I've got two forks and a spoon. So before we dig into these, I'm going to tell you a little bit about what we're doing. There's a lot of competition. With the amount of eateries and cafe in the Altrincham area. So to stand out, I think you need to be a bit different and be very good at what you're doing. So I usually go for coffee with friends in the week. I do put things up about that sometimes. Usually to various places, but I always come back to Sweet Octopus. And this place has found a niche in the market. It's a different kind of cafe. It's actually a patisserie. So, it's a Tokyo-style patisserie serving authentic Japanese desserts, like these here, inspired from the French art of patisserie. They only use the freshest ingredients, and all their products are controlled with levels of sugar and saturated fats to create light and guilt-free treats. I actually think you can have two if that guilt-free. So, I brought some of these delicacies today to try. So I'm just going to move the plate around so you can have a little look at them all. That one I accidentally, you know when like the box tips over and half of the topping comes off? Yeah, that was me, that was my fault. I'll introduce them all in a second. This one, have a look at that. Honestly, it's delicious. So we're going to start off with this one, the one that I dropped. I'll put this to the front and I will hand you. Well, I didn't drop, I got...
Okay.
Press the top of the box in by accident and I took half of it off. So honestly, try a little bit with the glaze on and dig into this. I want and well, it's gone to take right, I'm having it. Five second rule.
Take two.
Yeah. So Andy, you try it.
Okay.
Oh, that's so good.
Don't tell me about it. You want to never tell you that.
It's really good. What do you think of that? I think that's absolutely gorgeous. So that is the souffle cheesecake.
Nice.
It's so light and fluffy. I found out about Sweet Octopus because someone actually bought me a souffle cheesecake when they were leaving the Albert Ballet class because they were going down to London. And they brought this big cake in for all the ladies to share and I just went, where's that from? It was delicious.
Nice, very, very nice.
It's good. So, a bit more about Sweet Octopus. They actually supply desserts to Yo Sushi. Mm. So they've been doing this now since February 2016. And they've opened the shop, Sweet Octopus, since September, actually, last year. So that would be 2016 as well. What they do, basically, is serve desserts that are very common in Japan. Other ones that they do are like a matcha miso cake, which is like a tiramisu, but with green tea. They've also got a strawberry short, which is a French dessert, but you find it all over these Japanese patisseries, and the people in Japan just go absolutely mad for them. Now, let's try another one before I tell you a bit more, because I can see you looking at these ones. Let's go for the green one. And I want you to try one of the beans inside and tell me what you think. Your honest opinion on this. So this is what it looks like. It's got cream in, and it's got these special beans in. And I know it's green, that's the green tea.
Okay. And those little things there are the beans, presumably. That's dig in there then. I'm not going to be so adventurous on this one.
Is it the colour?
No, yeah, it's rather...
I find it quite nice. I think it tastes healthy, but it's nice. What do you reckon?
I reckon I taste with my eyes.
Okay.
That's got a bit of a tang to it.
It has. And you know what? That would be the adzuki beans. So it's a matcha green tea roll. And we soak these beans for 3 days in sugar and water. And then they roast them so slowly. But that's such a common dessert in Japan. I quite like that. I think it's really light. Just everything that they make is very light. But it is personal preference. Yeah. Just before we go into the next one, it's actually the brainchild, Sweet Octopus, of Taco Horton. And Leon Alexander is the operation manager there. And you'll always find him there. They also make hot food, curry pans, chicken katsus, which are out of this world. There's only those two that they make. So good. They also import the loose leaf teas. They're not specialty teas, they are loose leaf teas. You only get specialty ones in Sainsbury's or stuff. So afraid so. So it's like if you've ever heard of teas like Oji or Kyoto Bancha, two types of sensuous teas. I've tried those actually, they're very good. And toasted rice and green tea. They're really good. But the matcha green tea, you can have matcha green tea and matcha latte tea, and they're very good, they're very high in antioxidants. They're just good for everything, energy, some people are reporting weight loss off them. They're fantastic, and you can actually buy these teas for $14.95 for a pot about that big. And I've actually bought some, I think they're brilliant. Right, let's go on to the next one. This is what I call the boob. It's the Princess Swan Bar, so it's got... raspberry in it, it's got a little surprise in there. It's got a sponge base, and it's I'm going to show you the inside of this. It's got raspberry, can you see that inside? It's got the raspberry in it, and it's just delicious. Have a go with that one, see what you think. I'm just interested to see someone else's opinion on these cakes. Has anyone been to Sweet Octopus here and tried the cakes? Or the curry pans or the teas. I'd like to know what you think of it. Because I actually think this is one of the best patisseries or cafes that you can find in Altrincham. And they're on Moss Lane at the moment. They're just up from the football ground. And I really think they've found something that other cafes don't have here.
I'd say so. That's very strawberry.
Is it strawberry? It's raspberry.
Raspberry. It's raspberry. No, bloke!
So, right, lastly, this, for me, is the best of the lot. This is, I'm not sure, it's the creme brulee, actually. It's beautiful, so it's got a little hard top on. Dig into that and see what you think. I am taking an extra large piece of this because it's so good.
Oh, okay. A little like custard cream.
It does, but try it and tell me what you think.
That just melts in your mouth.
That is melting in your mouth, isn't it?
That
Is that not one of the best crème brûlée you've ever tasted? I know it's cold.
If I knew what one was, but that's nice.
It's serious. It is like ambrosia.
That is very, very good.
It is good. So what's your opinion on these marks out of 10?
Out of 10? Well, I'm not a fancy cake person, or I never thought I was, but those are so nice. They've all got to share at least a 9.
Yeah, definitely. I've got to give a 10 to the souffle. I don't think...
That's particularly nice, though.
I don't think you can find one better. So the reason why I'm going on about sweet octopus, and I had to bring these in because I've been banging on about sweet octopus, and I thought, you need to see the cakes, you need to try the cakes. They're doing the Doki Festival. It's actually the Doki Doki Festival, which is on the 11th of November. And it's basically celebrating all Japanese culture. So it's one of our local shops, a really good one, going to this place in Manchester. And it is going to be at the Sutton Sports Centre, which is off Grosvenor Street in Manchester. You can buy tickets for these. I've got to say I haven't been online. I think they're about £12 a ticket, or you can buy family tickets. They are basically celebrating just Japanese culture. And it's all about dressing up, as in Comic-Con characters as well, gaming, Japanese food. There is a free after-party as well from 9 till 2 in the morning, if you want to go just as adults. But go and support Sweet Octopus. Go down, try the cakes, see what you think, and I'd love to hear back from you. Just for your opinion as well, because I've got to say, I rave about it. I think it's absolutely amazing.
Okay,
let's
pop down another one
and
try those.
Yeah, try the curry pans. But the thing is, I mean, Altrincham has so many eateries. There is a lot of competition with them, so something has to stand out, and I think these guys really do. They do, in my opinion, anyway. So, there you go. Dig into the cakes.
Have you got any more over there?
No, we have them there. You can dig into those if you want.
Have you not brought any Marmite? We discussed this before.
We did discuss it.
Yeah, I
like Twiglets, but I hate Marmite.
You're weird.
I like Twiglets, but I like dipping them in hummus.
Oh, you'd get weirder.
Oh, I like them.
Okay.
That's what I like. I'm not as bad as Mrs. P. She likes jacket potato with fried rice and baked beans on top. Now that's a really weird combination. But people do, they have these really weird combos sometimes that, you know. She's got weird eating habits. So, we've mentioned the Altrincham lights as well. So, if you've got any questions about anything we've said tonight, please do call in, ask us anything that you like. What time are we on now?
We're running at 20 minutes at the moment. I just apologise, there was a call coming through while Kate was talking there. I couldn't actually get to answer it properly, so please try again.
Please call back.
07874 055 611 if you'd like to comment on anything we're discussing tonight.
Yeah, definitely. There's also, have you seen the new plans for the retail park since they've been bought out?
A bowling alley. Altrincham needs a bowling alley.
I quite like bowling. I'm not very good at it, but...
And what other retail park do you know that hasn't got a bowling alley? Pretty much all of them, haven't they?
The last time I went to one was Pars Wood. But we went for the pool tables, so I'm hoping they're going to have pool tables there as well. You know, they have the foosball tables as well. You can have a bar there if you want to have a drink. Yeah, I think it'd be quite a nice little...
Yeah, you need somewhere like
extra in Altrincham.
Here we go. Yeah, you need something leisure over that way, don't you? Okay, somebody is trying to call us. Bear with me while I get this fired up. Hello there.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi there. Who are we speaking to?
I'm sorry, who's that?
John.
Hi, John. You've got a very high voice. Are you all right?
Are you sure that isn't Billy Bradshaw?
I thought it was Billy Bradshaw as well. Billy, does your man know you're on the phone? You've just what?
I just pulled the phone off my older brother.
Oh, he's not going to be mean to you for doing that, is he? No, us older brothers alike. Are you still there, John? I think his brother might have...
He might have got his phone back.
He might have got his phone back and giving him digs right now. Oh.
No.
Oh. Oh, we can't hear you. Oh, dear.
Oh, that's not a very good signal.
It's not a good signal, is it? Well, listen.
Thank you for that.
Well, thank you very much for your call. I think he called up because he wanted some cake, to be honest. I thought that was Billy Bradshaw.
It was, it sounded so much like
that. Was Billy Bradshaw. Right, ladies and gentlemen, we do have some firework displays going on as well this weekend. So, if you are interested and wondering where to go, we have the, let's just have a look, the 49th annual bonfire, Bowden Bonfire and Fireworks Spectacular. I've been to this and it is pretty amazing.
Yeah?
Yeah, they put on a really good display. Gates open at 6 p.m, 7 p.m. for the children's display. 7:20, the bonfire is lit, exactly on 7:20 as well, they've never been late. 8 p.m, second display. And 8:45 is the grand finale. So, you know, you've got a good few hours there on this. There's going to be amusements there, barbecue, there'll be bars as well. They do food, the food's really good. The prices, if you buy in advance, on the night, a child is £5, an adult is £10, a family of two adults, two children, is £26. The gate price, though, is child £8, adult 14 and over, that is 50. And family £40, so with this, there is a significant increase as well. So go online, book your tickets. Again, that's the Bowden Cricket, Hockey and Squash Club. You're going to find that on South Downs Road in Bowden. So that's like basically one of the best that you're going to find around there, I personally think. If there's any others you know about, let us know.
Please do.
But I'm plugging the Bowden one because I reckon that one's absolutely amazing. Right, I think it's time to draw this prize.
Before we do, can I just say, I'd just like to correct myself on something I said on Sunday. I was talking about our Altrincham, Altrincham and Bloom. I said that if you wanted to get involved, that the final litter pick of the year had taken place. I've since been informed that is not the case. So if you'd like to get involved in this last litter pick of the year for our Altrincham and Altrincham and Bloom, we'll post a link on the page for you, and that takes place on Sunday the 19th of November. Mm-hmm. So watch out for that on the page.
Good. Well, we all make mistakes. Human error. It's all right. Okay, so shall we draw this prize?
I think it's about time, yeah.
I think so. So we have our little box full of people. So Andy, would you please do the pleasure of drawing?
Should that not be the ladies' prerogative?
No, I'm not. All right. Okay. Right.
Okay. Let's do this properly.
We were going to put it in the bin, but we thought no, we can do it in here. So give a big rummage around. Okay. So the prize for the two tickets to Warhorse on the 16th of November is going to Andrea Harrison. Well done, you've won yourself two tickets to Warhorse in Liverpool. The show starts at 7:30 p.m. So we are going to, in fact, I'm not going to screw that up because we need to send you a message so you can come collect your tickets. Congratulations, let us know what it's like. And we look forward to hearing back from you from that.
You know what you said just before about everybody makes mistakes?
Yeah.
I think you'll find that says Andrea Harris.
Harris? Oh, I haven't had my tea yet. Oh. In fact, yeah, I'm tired.
Either way, Andrea.
Well, Andrea Harris, well done.
Yeah, watch out for a message from us, or if you'd like to contact us, and we'll work out a way of getting these tickets to you.
Yeah, absolutely fine.
Hope you have a good night.
Yeah, us too. Right, I think I've said my lot for the evening.
Yeah, I think we're done. Should we take this final call that's coming through?
Oh, is it going to be Billy again?
Let's just see who this is.
Or John, sorry.
Hello there.
Not really clever dropping that M-bomb, really, is it? But it doesn't matter.
Okay, okay.
Okay.
So I think our time here is through.
It is. And remember, children, don't nick your older brother's phone.
Oh, no.
especially if you don't know how to interact with
people.
You
think it's easy peasy, but it's not.
No, really. Right, okay. Well, it's good night from me.
And it's good night from me. Well, I'll see you again on Sunday evening, I believe.
Yeah, and hopefully I'll be here next Wednesday. And I'll have some new topics for you to talk to.
I'm sure we will. If there's anything you'd like us to discuss, then please drop us a message on the page and we'll include it. Anything you'd like us to look at in particular.
Great. So,
yeah.
Brilliant. Thank you very much for tuning in. See you soon, Altrincham.
We'll see you later, Altrincham. Take care.
Take care.